Yohanan Plesner, the president of the Israel Democracy Institute, joining me now. We are likely momentarily to see the exit polls for some of these smaller parties, which will be important, won't it? But as we take a look at these initial exit polls, your first thoughts?
Well, if those initial numbers are correct, and we have a long history with exit polls that are incorrect, if they are correct, we can say they demonstrate quite a dramatic outcome, and it means that Mr. Netanyahu will no longer be prime minister. So, you know, for Israel, Netanyahu was first elected in 1996. For 13 years out of the last 23 years, and consecutively for the past 10 years, he very much shaped our public life and our international posture. So if those exit polls are correct, it's a demonstration both of the vitality of Israeli democracy, because turnout was actually higher than 4 months ago. We did not have voter fatigue.
Were you surprised by that? Because everybody said, and everybody I've spoken to here since we've been in town have said, people are just fed up of this.
Right. So don't listen to anyone, because actually, look, in Spain and in Greece and in the past in Canada, when they had two consecutive election campaigns, then the numbers dropped, the participation rates about 3 to 7%. In Israel, this time, there was actually an increase. We don't have the final results, but somewhere in the order of 2 to 3% increase to 70% participation. And since not all Israelis are in the country, it's effectively closer to 80%. So Israelis are very involved. They care a lot. And the outcome is very different than what the polls were before.
And it would be really interesting to see who came out to vote. That will be critical, won't it? The Arab Israelis didn't get out and vote last time.
Right. So that's we can already say that with Israeli Arab citizens, about 20% of our population in the previous election campaign 3 months ago, they came out with 49%, less than 50, whereas the average among Jews was about 70%. Now we're seeing that there was an increase around 62-63%. We don't have the final numbers, and that changes the balance of power between the political blocs.
Why do you think that was? Why did they come out and vote this time?
Well, it has to do with, I would say, three factors. Mm-hmm. Number one, the joint Arab list, so the Arab Israeli-Arab politicians got together. Number two, blue and white, headed by Gantz, communicated to the Arab minority that they care about their issues, mainly personal security and safety and so on. And number three, I think it has to do with Mr. Netanyahu's campaigning. He tried to fire up his own base by threatening from Arab misconduct and so on, and he ended up also motivating the Arabs to go and vote. So it's the law of unintended consequences.
What about Avigdor Lieberman? What will he want tonight?
Well, again, let's be very cautious. Mm-hmm. Assuming those exit polls indicate that Netanyahu does not have a 61 majority with his religious right-wing and ultra-Orthodox parties, that turns Avigdor Lieberman into the new kingmaker.
This is the former defense minister. He used to be very close to Bibi Netanyahu.
He used to be Netanyahu's director general, close ally, his defense minister, but he moved out of the right-wing plus ultra-Orthodox bloc because he was fed up with Mr. Netanyahu's capitulation to the ultra-Orthodox parties in questions of religion and state. If you take it in the American language, it's the values discussion. So the ultra-Orthodox parties, their appetite grew, and they wanted to control more and more and monopolize questions of religion and state. And there was a growing chunk. And if the exit polls are correct, we can see that it's a significantly growing chunk of Israelis that said we want to self-identify as right-wing, but it does not mean that we want to accept the package of capitulation to the extreme religious parties.
Last time around, 5 months ago, there was a definite Trump effect. Did you sense that this time? How does Donald Trump, how does the US play into what has happened tonight?
Well, the relationship with the alliance with the United States is extremely important to Israelis, and it's considered a part of the job description of any Israeli prime minister to get along with a U.S. president. Having said that, the current campaign was a rerun of the previous campaign, and while Mr. Netanyahu tried to again brag with the relationship with Mr. Trump, the other parties pretty much mimicked Netanyahu, both in terms of the get out the vote efforts and in terms of not letting him define the agenda only on the question of the relationship with the Americans and so on. So, I mean, when you repeat the same trick three or four months later, it has less of an effect. And one last point. Before the last election, Mr. Trump granted the Golan Heights election gift to Mr. Netanyahu. This time, there was no tangible gift.
We're going to take a very short break. Stay with me. This is an important night, an extremely important night in Israeli politics. And if anybody tells you that Israelis are fed up, fatigued by these elections, weren't going to show up, well, they have. Netanyahu is hoping to gain from his relationship with President Trump. We've just been discussing that, even though their friendship might not be as strong as it once was.